We are the Lollies. We will invade your planet and turn all your men into meadows.
Time's up.
さあ、クドウララランド、ポドカスト。
ユピカイ、マダパカ。
Losers always whine about their best. Winners go home and fuck the prom queen.
Lala
was the prom queen.
I don't care what she was. Now, Jesus, you're gonna listen to me real good, all right? This is probably the shittiest Sean Connery in the history of podcasts. But I really want to do a Sean Connery voice, even if I can't do it right.
Actually, see? You kind of sound like a 90s, 20s gangster, see?
That's right, see? Yeah, see? Because I can't do voices, see? I have no talent, see?
One, two for me, see?
Oh, boy.
What about me, boss? Oh, my God. That Looney Tunes skit just jumped into my head. That guy's awesome. Bugs Bunny's the best.
So I figured out what happened to Japan, Jesus. I figured it out.
Lay it on me.
I want to jump into this because we got a lot of ground to talk about today. I'm sorry. I'm just going to blow past your Looney Tunes bullshit.
It's fine.
I did a bit more research and I looked at the agency that hires Lala Kudou and I looked at their hiring page. And I was wondering if you wanted to spend some time talking about it. Now, we don't have to. If you want to jump right into the video, we can. But this is some interesting context, I think, for us to understand what this woman is doing.
Let's let the fates decide.
All right.
Hey, Google. Should we? But, yeah, Google says yes.
Oh, really?
Okay. Lay it on me.
I just sent you a link to the Zeal Group. This is the agency that manages Lala Kudou. And what we see here, if you click on the AV model job,
okay,
a lot of interesting detail about the job. And I'm just going to read the Google Translate of the page. The title is AV is recommended in big text if you want to get high income easily. Although after looking at Lala Kudou's videos, I have to say this is not easy at all. This looks very hard to me. But, well, what do I know?
I think they added an extra word there accidentally. I think it should be AV is recommended if you want to get high easily.
It does help. That is for sure.
Oh my God, look at this. I want to learn a lot. Mm-hmm. I want to earn a lot in a short time, quote unquote. Then another quote, I hate hard work.
Yep. So there are three reasons on this page. But yeah, what does it say? It says, I hate hard work. Where do you see that?
The very first
one. Right. Yeah, right off the top. I want to earn a lot in a short time. I hate hard work. Why do you recommend AV to everyone who thinks? It's very easy, safe, and secure, but it's super high income. And then it gives three reasons. I mean, the first one is simple reason, because you can always be passive, which basically says the AV industry, everyone's professional. They will give you perfect instructions on what to do. So you can just leave yourself to the main character and that's it. Which is kind of echoed in what Lala says in her interview, that she shows up, she does what the director tells her to do. That's kind of what number one is saying, which is interesting.
Zombies. Sex zombies.
Join our sex zombie army, which is very disturbing. Second.
Sexy sex zombies.
Sexy sex zombies. The second reason is reasons for safety and peace of mind, which basically says everyone gets tested all the time, so you're not going to get AIDS. The third reason is the real one, super high income. And dude, look at the pictures. They have like three little clip art photos next to it. One is someone carrying a bunch of bags from department stores. Another one is makeup. Yeah, and another one is a high-rise condo. Yeah.
Shopping. And a building.
Uh-oh. Well, oh,
which
God.
Which actually kind of looks like my condominium.
Well, yeah, I mean, I didn't want to tell the listeners, but the sequel to this podcast is going to be me and Lala Kudou reviewing your porn videos. I am not looking forward to that at all, especially because, not because I don't want to see you have sex. I've seen that 1,000 times.
It's going to be on the TikTok of porn videos, where videos are just 5 seconds long.
It'll be like those ads on YouTube, the 5 second bumper ads.
Yeah. And that's why AB model work is recommended for, quote, simple, safe, and high income, quote, jobs.
Mm-hmm. Blow jobs, hand jobs,
rim jobs,
pegging jobs.
Jobs. And the Steve Jobs. Have you heard of that?
Steve Jobs. I've seen the Mickey Tony Jobs, but I haven't seen the Steve Jobs.
Yeah, the Steve Jobs is when he, you know, when Lala is supposed to do a amazing technological discovery and announce it in the Apple style conferences and shit, right?
That would be funny. I would love to see Lala Kudou on a stage like that.
And then it's called I Bukkake. Then everyone there is just all porn actors and just bukkake her for like a whole hour and 30 minutes. I think it's up for an Oscar.
When she took a bat and she smashed that apple into bits, that was the only Apple presentation I've seen her do. And that one was actually pretty good. Yeah.
Oh my God, they even give statistics. Rich style. Quickly. A lot.
This is the meat of this, and this is what I really wanted to talk about. So you can see that there are basically two tiers of workers. There's dream style and there's rich style. Rich style is like the casual Uber driver version of being a porn star, where basically
there's three. Oh my God.
Oh, there's three? Oh, there's free. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm thinking of freestyle. Three. Right. So freestyle, that one they say gets you an average monthly income of 800,000 yen.
Yes, correct. Yeah.
You'll earn anywhere from 30,000 to 200,000 yen per shoot. Now, hold on a second. 30,000 yen is $211.
Yeah.
So these girls are working at the lowest tier. For example, the old hag lesbian. I'm sure she's making like $200 per shoot. That's the lowest that it gets. And if you're a girl doing porn and that's what you're making, I highly suggest renting a car, renting a garage, and buying a hose. That's all I'm going to say. The second tier, the middle tier, you're going to start out at 150,000 to 800,000 yen.
Yeah.
So that's...
rich style.
Yeah, so starting at like $1,000 per shoot, which is pretty low, but kind of respectable. And this one is for inexperienced girls who, I want to earn more efficiently than cabaret clubs and customs.
Cabaret clubs and customs.
I don't know what customs means. I think it's talking about like blowjob bars and stuff like that.
No, I think it's a default job for women. They work at the Japan Customs Agency.
Oh, I see. They have to keep all the men out.
Yeah, or something like that.
Yeah. Well, actually, see, that's a problem that Japan has had for a very long time, because they've had, as you know, they've had invaders trying to get into Japan for hundreds of years. And what really has traumatized Japan and turned it into the fucked up place that it is now is that actually, Jesus, I have a bombshell to tell you. We'll get back to the numbers.
Yeah.
Shit, that's boring. Let's not talk about that yet. Well, I'll leave it as a teaser. We will uncover how much money Lala Kudou has made in a bit. Before that...
nice.
I need to give you some context about Japan. So Japan was invaded by lolis. And these were lolis from another planet that came to basically turn Japan into a nation of pedophiles. And they fought back, you know, bless them. They tried. They fought their hardest. Mm-hmm. And they really did try to fight back.
Ah! That's right! That's right! Get up! Get up! That's what you get! Look at you!
Pussy.
Ball banged up! Who's the man? Who's the man? Wait till I get another...
penis.
I'm lining all your friends up right beside you! Where you at, huh? Where you at?
That was so stupid. Japan.
Uh, That's what I call
Japanese pseudo child porn. I'll tell you later if Japan won or not.
My God. Yeah, that lead actor there is so badass.
Oh, yeah. He would never get cucked in public and act really, really cringy and embarrassingly on the most watched awards show in human history. No, he would never do anything like that. So the top tier that Lala is unquestionably at, they actually bumped these numbers up. Because the last time I saw this, the top level was 2 million yen. It's now 3 million yen. So if you're dream style, this is AV idol who plays an active part widely. Step up towards your dreams. And it's recommended for girls who want to decorate the covers of various magazines. If I do AV, I want to become famous and admired by both men and women. I want to be number one. This is Lala's tier. Now, the lowest amount is 800,000 yen, but the highest amount is 3 million, which is like $19,000.
Yeah.
Now, Jesus, I'm so sorry to tell you this. She now has 345 titles to her name, right?
Yeah, that's correct.
So that means that she, if she made the top for every video, she would have made 6.5 million. But even if she only made the top for the last 100 videos, which I think is more than
likely
conservative,
yeah.
That's still almost 2 million. So let's say she's earned, she's now like 21, 22 years old, and she's earned about $2 million. So if she came back to porn as Lala Kudou because her parents cut her off, well, she doesn't have that excuse to continue.
To continue doing porn, you mean?
Yeah, to continue. Yeah, exactly. I mean, if she was doing it for money, then she would have stopped by now. She's obviously driven by, well, she wants to be number one. Or maybe originally that was not her intention, but as she's gotten into this, she's kind of found her home. The other option, which I think is much more logical and likely, is that she's an alien who has come to Earth and is trying to turn us all into pedophiles. And this podcast is our first stand to fight back, Jesus. We have to fight back. We cannot lose this war.
Which is something we can do by enlightening our listeners, right?
Well, the only way we can do that is to talk about a Lala Kudou title.
Yeah, and that title for this week is, we're back to our one of our favorite studios, WAAAA. That's W and then followed by three A's. 235. And yeah, this title is amazing. A cream pie poisoning public flight woman who can line up rich old man's pursuit, seeding press, 20 consecutive large orgies, Lala Kudou.
Emphasis on lining up, de-emphasis on 20.
Yes, there was not 20. I can count.
when was this made?
So this was made around December 2022. December 30, 2022 was the release date.
December 30, 2022. So this is about 6 months ago, right?
Correct.
Okay. So we're talking, this is before the downfall of Lala Kudou as we have first seen it, if the late June 2023 video is in fact
any indication
the beginning or part of her downfall, and it wasn't just a fluke. Yeah, so this is going to be important to determine whether we can track how far back the downfall goes, if we can see hints of it in this video. That's going to be important to look at.
Or how fast, because I'm going to, spoiler alert, man, this is Lala Kudou at her best, I think.
Yeah, for sure. It's her at her best doing a very specific thing, whereas there are other aspects of her we don't see at all. What are the tags on this one?
So the tags goes as follows. Well, because I'm super perv, I chose the uncensored leak version. So that's the first tag. Slut, individual, promiscuous, cream pie, orgy, forced blowjob, HD, exclusive.
Yeah, so there's a bit of hint of rape there. There's a bit of raunchiness and also uncensored. Woohoo. Although it's not really uncensored.
Yeah.
It's just.
No, but not rape, though. Forced blowjob doesn't necessarily mean rape. It's just the face fucking styles that they did that we'll get into later.
I'm going to need to sit you down with a dictionary because forced sex is rape, dude.
No. I mean, forced blowjob is just the term they use to describe it, but it's not technically rape. It's face fucking.
So okay, so it's a misnomer, basically. It's consensual, yeah. Very, very aggressive, but it's not forced. I mean, I only am being a bastard and an asshole about these words because I'm both a bastard and an asshole. That's the only reason. It's not important for the podcast. I just want to be a dick.
Hey, you're not a bastard.
That's true. I was born in wedlock.
Yeah.
Didn't have a grand piano, though.
Yeah, but you got a grand molesting.
I did have a grand... Oh, God. I mean, it wasn't my grandfather.
I've been waiting. That was like 3 episodes since I did a molestation joke. So I just gotta give it
back. Jesus. I'm giving this to you gratis. You just had to slip that in.
Yeah, but no slipping. Just touching.
Okay. Description. let's very quickly move on.
The description is a hell of a word salad. So, recent bud, jumping semen, covered seating, press 20 consecutive orgies, 140 centimeters. Perverted beautiful girl, Lala Kudo's minimum body pile driver, piston giant slaughter. Decaching waist crumbles, sleeping black back press, wall done standing back and pressure deep throat, endless seating press orgy, and demon cum rush turned into a semen public flight. Wow. Woman of rich men.
That's rather poetic.
The pleasure of throwing yourself into a tiny crack, ... It's the best.
So, funnily enough,
I'm sold.
I know, right? That is word salad, but somehow I understood all of it. I don't know how.
Yeah.
That was actually the most comprehensible description we've had so far.
Yeah, actually, that's my whole review right there.
I mean, the thing about this video is that, like, We don't have a story. We don't really have any plot. I think there's a very thin plot that is kind of put in a couple of voiceovers.
I was going to ask you about that because the way it started is she was introducing herself. So with your linguistic abilities, your cunning linguist.
I couldn't really catch anything in that very first scene to identify who she is or what the story was. There was a voiceover later in, I think after the second or third scene, in which she says something like, my life is now this, being with a bunch of different men.
Oh, right. Yeah, it's like right before a lot of dick sniffing scene, right?
Yes, exactly. And she says something like, now I'm surrounded by penises and I enjoy it.
Yeah, because I think that's the whole fucking theme for this.
That is the theme. But I don't think we know why. I don't think we know why she's surrounded by dicks. Or it might have been in that first conversation and I didn't, or in that first monologue.
Yeah.
But I just didn't pick it up.
Yeah, because apart from this first scene where she just does her solo work, where she was fingering herself without trying to lick her nipples and failing. That's the first scene is just her solo work. And very sloshy, actually. I mean, kudos to the mic guy.
And good.
Yeah, and good.
It was great. It was an excellent, excellent masturbation scene. It was very long.
Yeah, about 8 minutes long, actually.
It was very detailed. I think this would last more than...
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is going to last you a few sessions. But it's all good stuff, I would say.
She kept her high heels on at first. And then she gave, another... fan service for the foot into enthusiasts because she took off her shoes and changed positions. And I was going to ask you about that too. Do you think women actually change positions like that when masturbating?
I have asked and I've been told they do not. But women lie all the time, so they probably do.
Yeah, I mean, because as a man, I just like sit down or lie down wherever position I was at that time. Yank went out.
One of the worst things about getting older is that the positions in which you can have an orgasm in diminish, not just for masturbating, but for sex. I mean, I used to masturbate on massage chairs so intensely that I would lift off into space. Nowadays, I can only have an orgasm when I'm sitting
was that,
or laying down.
Was that in the store?
Oh, yeah, I never told you where I did it. Yeah, it was in a store. Actually, it was in a Sharper Image in the mall in Gardenia, California. And I had to pay to fix the hole in the roof in that mall as well, which was so fucked up because the mall shut down like 6 months later. It's like, why am I fucking paying to fix the hole in the roof in 6 months later? Anyway, so yeah, I mean, I don't think that women do this. It's obviously for the audience, which compounds the theme of like Lala's entire performance in this video is I'm going to give you my A game. You, my fans, my viewers, you love me and you're going to see a lot of me. And I think that there's no real narrative to this. There's nothing really important in this video besides Lala saying to her audience, I am working my ass off to make you come.
Yeah. No, it's like, I'm Lala. I'm here. Watch me.
Yeah. It's like,
it's how that first scene basically plays out because she went slow at first.
Yeah. Yeah. Because it's a Loli invasion. She's basically trying to say to all of Japan, all right, you're going to become pedophiles. Watch this and you will be pedophiles. And you know what, Japan? When I'm done with you, I'm going after all of Asia and America. You're fucking next.
And it's amazing. I swear. I mean, there's a part where she actually sniffs her pussy juice as well. And it's the sloshing sound. I swear. I just can't get over the fact about that. It's like, wow. What mics did they use?
Yeah.
It's like amazing. And a great angle for feet as well. She moved the two fingers while she was in that position. It's like, yeah, this is great shit. And that happened for about 8 minutes or so. Yeah.
If I can pull you into Jesus's slosh corner, do you think that those sounds were real or do you think that it was sound effects? Now, well, I'm not going to give you my opinion first because you're a lying piece of shit. What do you think?
Honestly, I'm going to go with that this is real, right? Because I know I joke a lot about not understanding if women could really finish or not, but I do think that in this case, given how good of an actress Lala is, I'm going to go with I think it was real. Real slosh.
Yeah, I think so too. I think that she was really enjoying it, right? I mean, it's possible that they added a bunch of liquid in her pussy, like put in some KY jelly or something to make it
wetter. Or you can ask him if he was thirsty.
But it's going to have... the pussy's still gonna have to have some residual moisture to it for the KY to work. So I think that she was like genuinely enjoying this.
Yeah, I mean, she's already what, 2 years deep into making porn. I would imagine she'd be enjoying this one.
And the other interesting thing about this video is that the next scene, she looks like she's enjoying too. I mean, the first scene with the guys.
So after that solo scene, right, in the first eight minutes or so, there's no, as you mentioned, there's like a very thin plot here. It's like just pure unadulterated sex, like Lala at her best, because the second scene just starts with two guys that are sitting or kneeling in front of her while she's sitting on a leather couch. So there's a black leather couch in this specific video. Which made the unfortunate farting sounds, and I just couldn't get over that fact, actually, for the rest of the first two scenes, for the rest of the second scene. And it was just very good, I think, because it started with two guys just firstly watching her masturbate, right, again. So she did that again, and then she was already wet. They were trying to emphasize the sloshing again. She pulls her finger up to their noses, right? And this one guy sniffed it. It's like, ooh, and went for it. So it's like the other guy got jealous. And that's how the whole sex thing in this escalates. It's Lala's pussy juice getting licked by two dudes in direct kissu.
And you can really tell throughout this scene just how much more harmonious of a culture Japan is when you compare it to America. Because these two men naturally take one side of Lala Kudou, do not go on the other person's side, with no words spoken. It is simply a tacit agreement. Whereas Mike and Tony had to several times hash out the finer details of which side stays with whom. And they were constantly policing it all the time. I mean, this is the problem with America, is that there's just no trust. Whereas these two men trust themselves complicitly.
And they'd know how to run a train on a girl.
Which we see a lot of. And I'm impressed how harmonious these two men interact. Because if you go to 1616, 16 minutes, 16 seconds, when she's on the ground and she's got her hands on both dicks.
Yes.
And you can see the guy on the left, on Lala's right, our left, his dick is so much bigger than the guy on the right. Did you notice that?
Of course, yeah.
I mean, even though there's some mosaic, but because this is the quote-unquote uncensored, mosaic is very weak.
You mean the guy on his left hand, on her left hand, has a bigger dick than the guy on her right hand, right?
No, the other way around. It's like the guy on the left side of the screen who's she's rubbing with her right hand. His dick, go back and watch it, dude. His dick is twice as thick as the other guy's.
Yeah, it was girthy. It was girthy.
Girthy as fuck.
Yeah, but I had a challenge with that harmony, though. I see the harmony, especially in the third and fourth scene. But in the second scene, there was harmony, but there was a bit there when Lala did her move that she wanted. I don't know why, but Lala likes doing it. But she liked to make dicks touch, the dickheads touch.
Which she did.
Which she did in the second scene. And the guy on the right with a thicker dick flinched.
Did he really? I didn't notice that. Oh, wow.
Yeah, he flinched back when the two dickheads touched.
Well, that's only natural. But he didn't freak out, dude. This is still a very harmonious society, man.
Yeah.
He didn't complain.
He didn't freak out. But if you watch that scene again, his hand was on the back of Lala's head for the rest of that blowjob scene.
Yeah, he got his revenge.
No, he was carefully watching. He's like, oh, don't do that shit, bitch.
I am thoroughly convinced that this is Lala's little, and it might be subconscious, but her little revenge against men when she does things like this.
Or girthy revenge.
If she had an opportunity to do a bisexual video, maybe she would do it, I think.
Maybe.
Anyway, the other thing I want to point out in this scene is at 1720, she's got an amazing arced back when she's doing a backwards blowjob. And her body looks incredible because she's not really crack whore Lala right now. But she's like, I would say like.
Yeah, she's. I think, this is where she was starting to lose weight again. And then, that face fucking from that position, that forced blowjob thing, right? I mean, that's where I thought as soon as I saw that. Yeah, this is where you see Lala at her best, taking two dicks at a time and just handling them like a champion. She's like...
Which she does throughout.
Yeah, because she did it all. She went ball sucking. She went ass licking. She's doing that bit when she talks to the dicks. This is her at her best.
And yeah.
She's just giving them the full service, full menu.
And then when it comes to actual sex, the way that it starts, this is at minute 18, this is incredible. So she's on all fours, she's giving one guy a blowjob, and she's lifted her butt high in the air. That beautiful arced back, which if you think back to her very first video, she didn't know how to do, and now she's doing it immediately. Oh, this is professional Lala Kudou, the porn star. And he just goes behind her and enters her.
Easily. Yeah, it's like there was a... Her vagina now had a homing dick beacon, I guess. An HDB, if you will, yeah.
It's a magnet. Dude, she's got magnets in her pussy.
Along with that flute. Or, sorry, that saxophone.
No, the tuning fork is in her ass. Oh, yeah, she's got that. Well, that's how she keeps the saxophone in place, is that the magnet kind of locks in because it connects to the metal of the saxophone. So I don't know if you notice in this scene as well, we get a beautiful view of her asshole.
Yes, we do. We got Morning Brown Star there. It's like, it was very good to watch. I was watching this at 10:30 a.m. in the morning. I was like,
And I mean, I was looking at that asshole because it's totally uncensored. And I was thinking, it would fit. Now, not only would it fit, I could sing the praises of how it would feel. But Jesus, I've been thinking about this because, I've been talking for a long time about wanting to fuck up the ass, right?
Well. Yeah, talking. You've even sang about it, if I recall correctly.
Maybe once or twice. No, that wasn't me. That was someone else. That was some weirdo.
Okay.
I think that anal honestly wouldn't be enough. We have to take it to the next level.
And what would that level be?
Well, to get to that level, I need an anal smith to help me.
Oh my god.
Oh, you recognize this already?
This is my childhood, man.
Armageddon,
this is my childhood. Yeah, man. It's Liv Tyler.
Yeah. I'm here to ruin it.
And Ben Affleck is that cowboy oil rig, man.
I still stay alive just to see you fucking. Watch you smile while you are sucking. But I'm far away and dreaming. I could end my life and have sweet surrender. I could stay in oblivion forever. But every vid you make with rape is a porn or a treasure. Don't wanna close my eyes. I don't wanna fall asleep, cause I'd miss you fucking. And I don't wanna miss a thing, cause even when I dream of you, the sweetest dream would never do. I'd still want your asshole, and for it I would do anything. This is a nice ball ad.
What?
It's a rock ball ad.
Ball ad.
Rubbing just to you, feeling my heart beating. And I'm wondering how I'd be feeling, wondering if I could be shrinking me so I am real small like Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
From Walt Disney Pictures, Professor Wayne Szalinski's shrinking machine accidentally has gone out of control.
What happened?
Honey, I shrunk the kids. I threw them out with the trash. They're in the backyard.
Now they're battling for survival. In the adventure of a lifetime.
What?
Rick Moranis stars.
Oh, this is my treasure.
In Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. Rated PG.
Starts tomorrow at a theater near you.
I want to shrink small and be in your cunt forever. Forever and ever. Just want to drive my ship up deep into your vulva, cause I love you, baby. And this pod is a normal thing, cause even when I dream of you, just normal sex would never do. I'd still need more Lala, so I go into your poonanan. I don't wanna miss one tit. I don't wanna miss one kiss. I just wanna be in you, right deep in you, just like this. I just wanna see your bones and feel your heart so close to mine. And just stay here in this body for all the rest of time.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Don't wanna be normal sized. I don't wanna be a creep, but I like you, Lala, in case you have not noticed. Cause even when I watch you screw, the sweetest vid would never do. I'd still miss you, Lala. No more pixels on her poontang. I don't wanna not be with her anymore.
My God.
I don't wanna be alone, cause I wanna fuck her, baby. I wanna be inside Lala Kudou.
Yeah.
Oh, just shut up, Steven Tyler. I'm fading this out. Man, shut the fuck up. God. Fucking annoying. Self-indulgent garbage. Yeah, I know it's about his daughter. I don't care. I really hate ball ads. Rock ball ads are like the worst music, in my opinion. I just can't stand them.
I like the balls, though.
Yeah, well, we get a lot of balls in this video. Jesus Christ.
Oh, my God, yeah. Because the second scene, like I mentioned, just watching this was a good, you know, respite from the last two vids we've reviewed. Because, yeah, this is her at her best. Takes dicks like a champ the whole scene. Many different all positions. And I've noticed kind of a trend in the theme, right? Because, yeah, the second scene just lays it on thick. She's... does that dick sniffing thing a lot.
Yep.
Yeah, and she finishes off with a cream pie in the prone bone position. So yeah, two cream pies.
And in this scene, she's really acting like just a lover of cock. I would say that's her character. I think the director just said to her, okay, you worship penises,
L-O-C, go. Lover of cock.
And then that scene gets us to what? That's to like minute 35?
Yep. So right? This scene starts at around minute 8 and finishes around minute 35. So a good 20 to 30 minutes of the first scene, thereabouts. And it just, again, there's no star really. So it just fades out while she was still on a prone bone position or all fours, I forget, with cum dripping out of her, which I think was real. It looked real to me.
Oh, yeah. It looked very real. I think the cum in this entire video...
I found weird. Yeah, yeah.
There's one scene towards the end
kind
where...
of iffy.
Yeah, on the mat, right?
Spoiler
the
alert.
Cum pool on the mat. Yeah, that looked a little iffy.
No. That was too much for three guys. I'll get into the science of the scene later. Okay. So, yeah. Okay. It's because that's the last scene. So, yeah. On this second scene, they finish with, I think, an acceptable amount of cum. And I think it was real. And they finished prone bone cutscene. And then in this second scene, she was wearing that blue, tiny blue bikini.
Which is
and
great.
And then the third scene, yeah, which is great, by the way. In the third scene, it's now orange.
Which is also great.
Which is also great. So I are we going to go through all the colors of the rainbow? Let's do this shit, right? So yes, scene three is the orange rainbow scene. And it's just more dick sniffing again.
I have a theory.
Oh, is this about rainbows and dick sniffing? Bring it on.
Absolutely. So I did mention that I think that Lala would do a video with two bisexual guys if she got the opportunity, because she, like us, is hashtag woke. And I think that she insisted in this video to wear all of the colors of the rainbow for Pride Month. The problem is she's retarded, and this video came out in December, so she kind of got the month mixed up, but she's doing her best.
Plus, she missed a whole lot of other colors, too. There's only four scenes in this video. Or maybe she's also colorblind. Colorblind and retarded.
Yeah, she's colorblind. She can't do math. Wow, okay. So it's not fraud. It's just retardation. Okay, I'm more comfortable with that. Okay, fine. So this scene ends.
I'm okay with retards getting fucked.
Because, well, if you weren't, then you'd have to be celibate. So
yeah, in this scene, though. Orange bathing suit this time. And was this the one with the... toy?
I watched this yesterday. I don't remember. It was either this one or the next one. I think it's this one because the next one is the cue.
Yes. No. The next scene is the three guys.
Yeah.
Right. I think, yeah, this one starts with her masturbating with a giant ass dildo. Right. I remember now because it's this big white dildo. Surprisingly, it's white.
A new
right?
dildo.
So it's a vibrator, actually. I think it vibrates, not a dildo. So yeah, it's a big white vibrator. So it's not like in the pinkish ones that we see in the June 2023 video. So this might be one of her legendary favorites, maybe. I don't know. Because it's big and white.
Yeah.
And she uses it for the first few minutes.
I prefer... the white dildo, because I find a massive, massive white dildo is much more relatable to me than like a tiny pink one or a tiny white one. Yeah, that a massive and white is very relatable to me personally. So
kind of like reminds you of your childhood.
Exactly. That's what I was going for. I wasn't implying I have a massive penis. Of course not. I would never be so arrogant.
You're in the present. <of it. laughs>
Oh, God.
You're the tiny pink one.
Okay. Jesus, I still am the tiny pink one. Why do you think I'm so angry? Christ. Hey, you think I grew out of that? You think I hit puberty?
No, but it sure hit you. Okay, so this scene starts off with two more dicks this time, and it's, I think, different dicks from the last. And so more dick sniffing ensues. And this time when she made her dick touch move, which I will say I'm starting to begin to think is her special move, these guys did not flinch.
Nope.
These guys took it in stride. I was like honestly waiting for them to kiss Lala also after get sucking the other dick. So it's like, ooh, indirect kiso and indirect sucko. So yeah, it was so. And yeah, these guys were more, what do you call this? They were more aggressive with their moves on Lala compared to the second scene. So because in the second scene, she did the back arc thing, right? In the couch, which looked so uncomfortable. But she also did the scene here, but this time with both of them, is that there's a part in this scene where she sits on her ass against the wall and the guys just proceed to fuck her in the mouth.
I personally would describe the men in this scene as more professional. They're just better porn stars. And I feel like the way that they're acting is at Lala's level, so she's more comfortable with them. Whereas the two guys, and don't get me wrong, I don't want to badmouth the two guys in the blue bikini scene were also professional, but not as much as Lala. Or maybe it was simply that they're all equally professional, but Lala kind of ruined it by having the two dicks touch, because she doesn't do that in this scene. She was told by the director to not do that again.
No, she did it here, and they did not flinch.
Oh, wow. So they are just are more professional. Really? I missed that. Oh, shit.
These two guys didn't flinch, right? So my theory is that the guy on the other day just got fired. Got switched with another dick.
That's a better theory,
More professional dicks. More dicks that won't mind touching.
Yeah, well, at this point, Lala is the star. She's the supernova. So they're like, hey, if you're going to complain, what Lala wants, Lala gets, okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and if you notice... aside from that face fucking against the wall, none of them had their hand on the back of her head when she was doing the blowjob scene in the beginning.
Exactly. Yeah. They're all being professionals.
Yeah. And it was a great scene, I think. So those two guys started getting a blowjob first after that solo work she did with a white dildo. And then, which we will name Michael for reasons unknown. And then, and then they proceed to go to town on her, right? Go to town on her and aggressively. But Lala was more keeping up with the aggression that those two were doing, because she was also looked like honestly legit enjoying the whole thing.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
For sure.
And again, I don't know if it's acting or not, but I got the feeling more that it wasn't that she was enjoying the sex per se, but she was enjoying the video shoot.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that is that, like, this is easy for her. Like, just having straight sex where she's acting like she enjoys it, or really more that she's just acting like a porn star having sex with a bunch of guys, because she doesn't, I don't think, really overplay enjoying it. She's not like going crazy.
Amazing. Yeah, she had realistic moans. Although I didn't like kissing moans that she does. I always find that weird in general, actually. But
are you kidding me?
No, I mean...
That's like my favorite thing she does.
No, I mean when she's moaning when they're kissing in the beginning. Not kissing while fucking.
That's what I mean too.
Oh, okay.
That's like my favorite thing she does do. Because it's like an intense enthusiasm. And actually, my girlfriend did that actually when we had sex this morning. I don't think she's ever done this before, or I just hadn't noticed it, but it was... Oh, it was wonderful. Maybe because I watched this video last night.
Subconsciously so, put in your hand.
Yeah. Oh, dude, it was not subconscious at all. No, not at all. Because I was so, so enjoying it. I'm like, oh my God, I don't know how she knew. Maybe I'm telepathic. Maybe I telepathically communicated it to her. Or maybe I just told her to do it last night when I was stoned out of my mind. I don't remember.
Or maybe you should disconnect your phone from all the Bluetooth speakers.
That's another good option. The other possible explanation is that she's a figment of my imagination.
Or that she's also Lala Kudou in real
life. Oh, dude.
Dun, dun, dun.
This scene, I only have a few things I want to point out in this scene. At an hour 7, they're doing doggy style while she's standing up and she's leaning with her hands on the wall. Absolutely
the wall.
Lovely. Yeah. Beautiful, beautiful position.
Beautiful. And they finished it on that scene. Well, not that scene. They finished it that way because the guys finished inside her in two separate occasions. So in this scene, there's more of a, there's a two-on-one action, but there's more of one-on-one compared to the second scene.
Yep.
Right. So yeah, In the second scene, they decided to finish it as a one-on-one, and they just changed places. So the face fuck while sitting first, and then doggy while standing, leaning against the wall. And then, of course, two cream pie finishes from both guys.
Lovelier.
And again, looked real to me.
Loveliest.
So yeah, after being face fucked into submission, they just cream pie her doggy style. And end scene. Transition. And amazing. It's like, well done.
Before the scene ends, at an hour 8:55 seconds, she falls to the ground with her head against the wall. And she looks like she's spent, right? But while she's in that position and she's got her head leaning against the wall, she has to be thinking. I mean, Lala Kudou, the actress, she has to be thinking, oh my God, what has my life become? How has it possibly come to this? And I actually looked in her eyes in that scene and I felt bad for her.
Really?
Yeah. I'm not lying.
Well, I felt good for her because she's just finish the scene and she can move on with the next one.
No, be honest. You felt good for her because she just got fucked by three guys, which is your ultimate fantasy. Be honest.
Two guys.
You're not a glutton.
Well, two guys and Michael. I'm not. The white dildo.
I'm not a guy. Oh, okay. All right. So, yeah, we get that. Oh, I want to point out.
Yeah, and that's scene three.
I want to point out also in... Was it the next scene where she's got the two pigtails?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Amazing hair. Amazing hair in the scene. And also, I want to point out her skin in the entire video is beautiful.
Yeah, and the light blue one-piece bathing suit, but had lots of skin showing. Yeah. It's a great bathing suit.
Yeah, so you could really tell. It was beautiful. Yeah.
Oh, and I think the second scene is where she squirts, right? Or was it the third scene? No. Third scene is squirting.
Yeah, it's the third scene. And she does get completely naked throughout the video, so we do see her in the bikini, but she does get naked, right?
Not fully. No, they just usually really? They just take the bottom off, but the tops are so fucking tiny, it's barely even there.
It doesn't matter. Just, yeah. I mean, you see her nipples many times.
She's technically naked, except for those strings around that breast area. That's it.
Yeah.
That second scene ends that way, and I think again, masterfully done. The two guys were pros, and they just...
Wait, you mean the three guys?
Two guys and Michael the White Dildo. It was pros in the second scene, in the third scene. And transition to the fourth scene where she's wearing the blue bathing suit with the pigtails. But this time, there's three guys fully clothed and she's on her knees in that bathing suit already. So that's how this starts.
Yeah.
And again, she starts sniffing the dick through the pants. So this is her move, her special move for the day. It's a theme.
Like, this is her move. It's an interesting one. It doesn't do anything for me personally, but...
She just takes deep sniffs. I mean, it's like... I think she's just channeling the first guy that sniffed her pussy juice in the second scene. So it's like, ooh, that's good. I mean, we should start doing that a lot.
Do you get anything out of that?
When a girl sniffs my dick or when I see someone... When I saw Lala sniffs the dick. Yeah, so those are two very different things.
Well, both.
Depends. For the IRL dick sniffing... Kind of gives me a chuckle, especially if I just went walking or it's been a long day and I haven't washed yet.
Oh yeah, you're gonna be self-conscious. I hadn't even thought of that. Yeah.
No, not self-conscious. I'm excited. It's like, yeah, I wanted.
Oh, I forgot you lack empathy. Right. So with Lala Kudou, how about that when you saw her sniffing?
Oh yeah, so when I saw her sniffing, I guess it got my attention, but it not in an arousal kind of way. It's like it got me on the edge of my seat, like, oh, she's gonna do something.
Right.
That's it. But not like, oh, that's a turn on, no. But it's like when she's starting to sniff dick and breathe heavily like that, it's like, ooh, I wonder what she's going to do. How deep is she going to deep throat this dick?
I think probably the problem is you are watching this with your professional porn critic hat on, so you can't really look at it in the same way.
No, honestly, that hat has been stuck for a while now.
So one of the funniest things about this scene is, this is at hour 27.
Yep, correct. This is the last scene and they go all out.
I don't know if you noticed this as well. This is the time when she's sitting on the couch. One of the guys is fucking her while she's sitting on the couch. And then there are two guys standing behind him, like in a queue. And they're standing.
Yeah, the train.
They're standing like they're on a Japanese subway train. Like they're standing like 2 inches away from each other, fully naked. And I could tell the way that the shape of the guy's torso in the back, he's trying to lean away from the other guy so that like he's not getting hard and his dick isn't touching the other guy. And I'm like, dude, step back. 2 steps back. What the fuck? Man, this is after COVID.
You have legs. You can move.
This is after COVID, man. You should know fucking personal space, social distancing, motherfucker, sexual distancing.
Yeah, but yeah, kudos to Lala. I mean, she still did the three dicks touching move.
Oh, so that's where she gets her name from.
I guess she was trying to summon the devil, I think. she formed a tri-dicorate.
Tri-dicorate. she's trying to do a triforce. She's trying to summon a Zelda.
Oh, yeah.
I think she needs to get 5 dicks and then she can summon Satan.
Yeah, but now she can just summon semen. Because that's what you got. You got a lot of it in this scene, which honestly, this time I start to find it unbelievable, right? Because again, the title says 20 orgies or something like that. And at first I was like, maybe they meant 20 cream pies. So I started counting that. So in the first two scenes, there's only about 4 cream pies, right? The two guys in 2 scenes each gave her 1. So that's 4. And the first scene was just a solo scene, so no cream pie there. And then this starts with a cue. So I was like, holy shit, are they going to like really try to hammer in all those cream pies in this last scene, in this last 40 minutes? And I think that's what they tried to do. Yeah, so after that triple dick touching thing, the cue thing starts.
Yep.
Right. And they just go to town on her on that couch first. And it's just changing positions and multiple cream pies until it ends up in that mat scene where they were giving her cream pie right now on a prone bone position this time again. And that's when the pool starts to form. So I counted at least these guys cream pied in her at least 3 times each.
So that's quote unquote. 9 total.
So that's already 9. Yeah. And then came on her face once each or one or two guys each. Came on her face, and then one guy still finished inside. So I counted about 12.
So some guys right, were shots. Led to believe came 4 times in one scene.
Yeah. So it's like, and that pool of semen was pooling around.
Okay, Jesus.
Cum shot number 2 or 3, right? So it's like, no way.
Because you are a racist, I have to ask this question. Are you sure that they didn't swap guys and there were more than 3 guys?
No, because the brown shirt, I kept watching out for that. They never showed these guys' faces, right? So I just saw that the guy with the brown shirt took turns.
Yeah, yeah.
Because one of them kept their shirt on while the others did not, right? And they ran a train on her. So yeah, I think it's the same 3 guys. Yeah.
Well, there was another guy who had a very distinct six-pack. He wasn't really buff, but he was lean and had a very muscular torso. And he stayed throughout the entire scene. So that's at least 2 of the 3. So we have to assume that the third guy as well was there the entire time.
Yeah.
And yeah, I guess just what happens in the scene is that she's so in, or I mean, I think they probably added some fake cum. But I think what we're led to believe is that she's just such a powerful lolly that she's just totally overpowered them and turned them into pedophiles. And then it fades to black, right?
Yeah. And then did it just fade to black? Yeah, there's no toothbrush scene this time.
Yeah.
It just ends.
No, it's because...
It just ends with a Lala lying on her back after that last guy came on her face.
And it fades to black with a close-up on her, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which is a very porn and ending.
Fin. Yeah, and fin.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I think this is just a collection of Lala's sex moves, I guess. She wants to document what she's learned the past 2 years or so into this one specific movie.
It's to emphasize her constitution and her agility and her ability to endure.
Yeah, and these guys didn't flinch again when the triple dick touch happened. So I think, this is just...
Professionals all around.
This is her just showing, I can take on 7 dudes and Michael, the big white dildo, all in one vid. And yeah. She did it well, I think. The sex scenes were shot well, and she wasn't... I don't think these were the scenes that she was overly stressed, like in those other rape
No,
ones.
Not at all.
But rough sex, sure. But yeah, all around, high fives for everyone. Lots of cream pies and a cum shot. So for the last scene, I think the cream pies were fake, but the cum
shot... Okay, that sounds fair. So, Jesus, is this the first stamina video that we've seen from Lala Kudou? Like, have we seen another one where she's fucking a bunch of guys at once?
This might be the first one that's not rape.
Well, even the rape ones, I think we only saw like two guys. We haven't seen her getting raped by like a dozen guys. Because Lala Kudou is good at stamina. We have not penetrated this part of her body of work. She does a lot. She does a lot of these stamina videos. And actually, she did it quite early in her career. If you remember that video she did with the creepy Eastern European / Irish dude, she mentions there's one video where she has sex with, I think, 23 guys, which I've seen. It is the grittiest, most sleazy, disturbing video in her corpus in Latin. It's really bad, but yeah, she's good at it. I mean, she can fuck a lot of men, which I think really hits a male ego, because I think we like this fantasy of like, when we fuck a pussy, we're fucking it raw and it's gonna hurt afterwards. It's not true. Vaginas are very durable, they're very strong, they can handle thousands of dicks and be the same total shape and size and have the same ability as before. They're like, they're stronger than fucking rubber. God bless women. Hashtag woke.
Yeah, you would know, yeah. And fucking rubber is something we do often.
Oh, you judgmental piece of shit. Like, you've never done that.
Yeah, I don't wear condoms.
Speaking of how strong lollies are, another plot point to this video is that we see that Lala Kudou is just too strong for the Japanese, Jesus. And when the Loli army came to Japan, basically what happened was it was too much. They could not win. And so they waved the white racist flag.
Holy shit, it's this. Oh my God,
there's much we can learn from each other if we can negotiate a truce. We can find a way to coexist. Can there be a peace between us? What is it you want us to do?
Come.
Yes.
Come.
Oh my God.
Is that glass bulletproof?
No, sir.
I didn't replace that with Lala moans because, dude, those are screaming cats. Seriously, they used fucking screaming cats for the sound effects. I mean, just listen again. Those are cats, right? Dude, they are, aren't they?
I didn't know this was going to be a lesson on Sound Effects 101.
Hey, man, I only noticed it when I was putting this together. It sounds like they basically got cats and they raised the pitch and distorted it a little bit, but it's basically a fucking cat. It could be a cat having sex, actually.
Yep, actually, now that you mentioned it.
I mean, my cat makes that sound every time I fuck it.
I was kind of hoping you'd end that bit with like the guards coming on the glass or something. But then again, these are Americans, so
Jesus,
they're stronger than the Japanese.
Exactly, they're fighting against the lollies. They're not coming yet. And also, Jesus, that's way too crass, dude. Man, you know, let's try to.
Oh yeah, that's not what we're about.
I know.
We're not about crass. We're about class.
That's right.
And ass.
Speaking of class, how many classes would you give this video from 1 to 5 Lala Kudous? Actually, you know what?
Me?
I'm going to go first.
Okay.
I'm giving this a 1. I'm giving it a 1 because it's a solid, solid production through and through, and Lala is performing at her best. This is the kind of video you could literally come 1,000 times to.
Yep.
In one.
Or
in one
4, because, you know, it's still early. But yeah, I mean, this is a Lala Palooza. I'm giving
Thank
this
you,
a
sir.
1 as
yes.
well.
Yeah, despite the urge to like suddenly give this a 1.1 just to piss you off. But yeah, I'm going to give this a 1. And this is fitting for a Lollapalooza for episode 24. Because yeah, they didn't need to do backstory. They didn't need to do character development. No, this is just Lala showing what she's learned the past 2 years and a half or so. On video number 200 plus or whatever by now. By December 2022. And yeah, that's her at her best.
Peak performance.
She was not too fat, not too skinny, and she.
No,
was
I liked
just
it the first time. Not too skinny.
Yeah, skinny, and she's just like into that decay. I was like, ah, sniffing the decay. I was like, and oh my god, she's like, I guess she got good allergy medicine the other day or something, or her sinuses were just clear that day. She just took in the dick smell for the whole shooting of this. Masterpiece. And I think I'm very glad that this happened very close to June videos, because maybe right, that you know, some people just have their ups and downs, and that video we reviewed the other day was just a down.
I mean, at the very least, the good news is we know peak Lala lasts until the end of 2022. At least we need to watch more 2023 videos. I wonder if there is some on the docket. We'll see.
We'll see. And oh my god, more porn? Fine.
I don't. This is such a happy episode. I feel like I don't need to be saved. Do you want to save me anyway?
But yeah, I just want to mention the last day. I'm also proud of Lala's ambidextrous qualities.
Oh, that she's jerking with two hands. Yeah,
she handled those dicks. She handled multiple dicks like a champ. Left hand, mouth.
Like, Jesus, this is the woman who can play two saxophones at once. She's ambidextrous. She's multi-ambidextrous.
Yeah, but can't play a pianica for shit, though. Anyway, so Jesus saves, I think. I don't know. This is just a purely masterclass thing, so there's really no saving. And I guess if there's any saving, that if anything we can do is just save the guys or our listeners the trouble. W-A-A-A. 325, guys. It's give it a watch. Have your girlfriends or wives watch it too, and then cause a fight.
Okay, I guess we don't need a theme. Okay, I guess we don't have to listen to the theme. That's fine. Fuck it. Who cares? Oh my god. I mean, okay. I have to say, this is a very Western.
WA 235.
It was WA 235. Did you miss? Speaking.
Yeah, I said 325. 235, 235.
Oh my god, what kind of professional porn critic is this? Mike, oy vey. You know, Jesus, we have been really far too America, Philippine centric in our view of this video, because we have not fallen to the lollies, but Japan did, and it is a tragedy. And also, we should be more forward-thinking. Yes, we can rejoice that 2022, the entire year, is peak Lala. But in the future, we are facing an attack of the lollies, Jesus. And Jesus, we will never let the lollies win. 24E, whenever you're ready.
I'm laughing already. Oh my god, is this what I think it is? Okay, ready?
It absolutely is.
I love that drum roll.
In less than an hour, Kamikaze lollies from here will join others from around the world, and you will be launching the largest lolly attack in the history of mankind. That word should have a new meaning for all of us after seeing all those lollies get raped. We can't be consumed by our petty differences anymore. We will be united in our common interest. Perhaps it's fate that today is the anniversary of the day we bombed Hiroshima. And once again, you will be fighting soulless monsters. Not for freedom or security or oil, but because they want us to be pedophiles. We're fighting for our right to fuck fatties, white fatties. And should we win the day, August 6th will no longer be known as a Japanese holiday, but the day when the world declared in one voice, we will not jerk off to children. We will not lust after your lollies. We're going to go on. We're going to survive. Today, we celebrate our old hag day.
I knew it.
By the way, America dropped the bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki on August 6th and 9th. Nice.
That president is brave and informative.
Okay, we're actually recording this a year and a month before, because it's July 9th, but who cares?
Oh my god.
Another one in the can.
I will not come silently in the night.